4. I was influenced by people like John Butler. I was influenced by Luigi, which is quite a jazz dancer and teacher. And but then you develop your own style, and you start to develop your own way of thinking, you know. So actually, I'm at the moment, I just do what I think is right for me, and that's what's important to me, you know. And I develop all the time. You don't stay still. I mean, you don't just go on. You go on and you go on. You got to, you know. So I'm really proud with that part. So when we see today on this videotape, for example, in the 6 months, it's going to be different dancing. Hopefully better.
Side, which way goes? 1, 2, 3, 4. Side, and stop. That's awesome. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3.
Hamburg Staatsoper, Wuppertal Stadttheater. I worked in Bavaria Film. I worked lots in Germany for about 7 years. And then I come to the United States and I got a job in Hollywood. I did movie. But after that, they told me I had to leave. So I went to Canada. I did their job called Ted the Fish, which is a Canadian variety show in Montreal for 1 year. And I tried to go back to the States. Boy, you know, that's what dancing is at, you know. I want to learn, I want to go back to Europe actually. That's what I want to do. I did want to return to Europe, but not before I know everything. So I took all those classes and I got a job on A Clear Day You Can See Forever. That's a Broadway show, original show. And I worked with Herbert Ross, who is very popular and known in dance circles. And now he's he's a director doing like Funny Girl, you know, all the Neil Simon movies. He's director now.
Mention that again, Herbert Ross.
Herbert Ross, yeah, he did A Turning Point, for example. He directed and choreographed. And I worked with him and I learned a lot from him, you know. And then I did work with John Butler, which is one of the foremost choreographers in modern dance in the United States. So in his company, when I danced with his company, were Glenn Tetley, for example. There was Carmen de la Vallade. There was Mary Hinkson. There was Lara Lubovic. He's got a big modern company now in New York. So there were lots of pretty good dancers, I would say. So the education there was pretty much beautiful, you know. And that's only America can give people education in dance. So I appreciate to be here. And then I got a job in San Francisco with ACT, which is an American conservatory theater, a repertory company. And the guy who ran the company, Bill Ball, he really thought The art should be everything. Painting, music, dance, speech, everything. Not just one part, you know. So he kind of integrated the whole arts together. So I stayed with them for about 4 years. And then I went back to Europe. And I went back to Los Angeles. I did Odyssey Theater there. And then I did go to Seattle. Gorgeous town. Very. Well, I'm here now 2 years. And I find it takes time to develop a dancer. I mean, to develop a dancer in the mold you think is going to work for you. You know, and I got now 6 people who are really working excellent. We got good rapport, and I think we're doing fantastic. Now, obviously, we're not going to stay in Seattle because Seattle doesn't give enough opportunity for this kind of group, money-wise. I mean, financially, it's absolutely difficult to make a living here. So what we try to do, get a group together and go to like different places, like Vegas, Los Angeles, different nightclubs. That's the idea. That's what people got to make. They got to eat. They got to pay rent. And I can demand from them to go and take my classes and work with me for nothing. You know, that gets boring after a while. After a while, they want to see results, make money.
Some of his many credits include working as a dance teacher for ACT in San Francisco, where he received rave reviews for his choreography of Miss Ethel Merman in the ACT. He's worked at Richmond Ballet, the University of San Francisco, Arizona Dance Guild, and he also choreographed the European productions of Kiss Me, Kate, and Hair. His television works include appearances on The Ed Sullivan Show, The Bell Telephone Hour, Hollywood Palace, and Camera 3. He was a featured dancer on Broadway, where he danced in On a Clear Day You Can See Forever, Paint Your Wagon, Roberta, and Little Me. I'm very proud to introduce our jazz teacher and a close friend, Mr. Marco Pochard. Thank you.
For jazz dancing, it's very important. Jazz dance, unemotional jazz dance, is not jazz dance. It's nothing. So that's part is important. You got to be emotional, and you got to put your soul into it. I'm not going to soul dance because it sounds too idiotic, but it got to put your feelings into it. You got to.
Marco,
just his energy and his commitment and his zest for doing it and doing it well. And this, I haven't seen any performances in Seattle of this nature, of this style.
I've been involved with Marco and his jazz company for about a month now.
So what do you think so far?
I love it. I've studied around with a few different people for the last 2 years, and I have never ran into anyone with as much energy, as much push, as much striving for perfection as he does. I want to do jazz dancing professionally with the company, and I'd really like to go with Marco Pochard, as you know, forever. He seems to be the one that's going to push for the top.
Vegas, but just to dance with the group, I really enjoy dancing with these people.
Well, it has definitely been rewarding because I've learned a very new style from what I've ever studied before, and it's a very energetic style. I like Marco's choreography, and I like doing it.
Well, we just in me that just loves to do it, and just it's just so freeing to me to just be up there and moving. I just love it.
Jazz is a lot looser, a lot sexier. I had a hard time getting sexy. Being sexy. Marco's dancing, at least, is very sensual, I think. And I had a hard time seeing myself do that.
Have you danced with anyone else beforehand, or is this your first dancing experience?
Not as a real student with somebody, you know, in particular. I've danced a few places around, but Marco seems to just get me in the right spot there, you know.
Great.
Get into my groove, you know.
You have to do everything. You can't be just a dancer. You got to act, you got to be involved with painters, you got to be involved with musicians.
Sure.
The very important part, you know.
Sure.
So that's what's important to me now. Sure.